Your new triathlon bike has come with disc brakes. And now it's time to travel to your first race with them. So, what do you need to know about traveling with disc brakes? Well, we're here to help. Disc brakes are here to stay. And yes, they're even on triathlon bikes. We're not going to debate the merits of them here today, but the fact is, if you're in the market for a new triathlon bike in 2021, it'll almost certainly have disc brakes. Now, the maintenance of disc brakes is actually pretty simple, and you might even have got your new bike already and just started riding in it with not much thought. Your disc brakes stopped you, so you didn't think much more about it. But now it comes time to travel to your first big race, and suddenly packing those disc brakes becomes quite intimidating. But you don't need to be intimidated by disc brakes, they're pretty easy to work with. So we'll explain today how to travel with your disc brakes. Don't worry, they needn't be intimidating. Soon you'll be as comfortable with your new disc brakes as you were with your old rim brakes. First things first, you need to get to know your disc brakes a little bit. You should probably have done this when you got your bike, but we understand. New bike day is a good day and you just wanted to get out there and ride. I've done exactly the same thing myself. But if you want your brakes to still work when you get to your destination, a little bit of knowledge about what goes where and why is important. So let's get through the basics first. First, your disc rotor. This is the shiny aluminium bit attached to your wheel. That obviously is slowed down by brake pads, just like all brakes. Those brake pads are two little square discs inside there, and they're pushed against it by pistons. The pistons, importantly, are normally self-adjusting. They're actuated obviously by your brake. When you pull your brake lever, a cable goes through there and makes them squeeze. Normally, these cables these days are hydraulic. You do still get cable actuated disc brakes, but they're pretty rare. So yours are probably hydraulic. The whole system is actually pretty simple. The hydraulic bit can be a bit intimidating though. However, it's a closed system. And even when you're traveling, at no point should that hydraulic fluid leak out. It shouldn't need any maintenance. If the hydraulic fluid does leak out, it's time to head to your local bike shop to get that sorted out by a professional. If you're traveling by car to your race, there's not too much to think about, but you'll probably need to remove one or both of your wheels to fit your bike in the car. And when you do, you'll definitely need these. They're disc brake spacers. They're little pieces of plastic, basically. And you could use cardboard or something else to stick in that disc brake, but these are £3 for 5 of them on Amazon. So just get some. You don't want your disc brake squeezing shut and causing you a whole lot of hassle when you get to the other end. If you're flying, a bit more time and care goes into the packing before you hand over your precious bike to the baggage handlers. Most triathlon bikes are designed with travel in mind, especially the newer ones. Triathletes travel because triathlons really happen on your doorstep. Your new bike may have come with nifty engineering to make it really easy to pack, like a two-part base bar or even its own travel case. If you didn't get a case, you may need to upgrade your bike bag. Disc brakes require through axles, so if your old bike attached to your bike bag frame using quick releases, like those of Bikeend or Thule or Cycon, it won't work for your new bike. You'll either need to get new adapters for the through axles or a whole new bike bag. Once you've removed your wheels and inserted those disc brake spacers, you can pack your bike as you normally would. Be careful not to twist or pull too hard on those hydraulic cables, but they're pretty tough, so don't worry too much. One more thing, before you pack those wheels, you should remove the disc brake rotors. This is a good idea even if your new bike bag has a nifty place to protect those brake rotors. And it's also a good idea if you're traveling by car. You might think, I've got somewhere safe I can put my wheels and nothing will touch them, but after a few hours on the road, something's going to shift and will be leaning on your precious brake rotors. It is very hard to protect brake rotors on a wheel that is not on the bike. You'll need either a bottom bracket tool or a cassette tool, depending on the type you have. This one's a bottom bracket tool. You will buckle your rotors if you try to travel with them on your wheels. It's an easy job to remove them. Then pack them somewhere safe in a Ziploc bag to avoid any grease or gunk on them, and in a firm box or next to something flat, and you're good to go. When you get to your destination, you've hopefully prevented any hassle with your disc brakes, by packing your bike well. Simply reinstall the disc rotors on the wheel, remove those spacers, pop the wheel in, and you should be good to go. But this is the real world, so your brakes might be rubbing a little bit, making that awful scratching, squeaking noise, and no one needs that kind of aggravation. Even if the noise is not costing you a single watt, it's very frustrating. But before you take a hammer or a wrench to that very obvious kink that you can see in your disc rotor, try loosening off the brakes a bit. On mechanical disc brakes, you can do this by tweaking the pad adjustment screw. On hydraulic disc brakes, you need to reset the pistons to a wider position. You can do this by forcing the pads apart using a screwdriver or a butter knife or even a tire levers in a pinch, but you'll probably damage the braking surface and be in for some new brake pads. Rather, get yourself one of these. It's a brake piston spreader. This one's the ParkTool PP 1.2, but there are a lot of versions out there. It might be the simplest tool you'll ever use. It doesn't seem logical, but once you spread your pistons on new hydraulic disc brakes, even after braking, they'll return to that new wider position. All hydraulic disc brakes are self-adjusting, so they'll settle into a new position about 1 millimeter away from your disc rotor. No squeaking or touching, but still predictable braking power. And that's it. Like most intimidating new bike tech, disc brakes are actually quite easy to work with once you get to know them. You should do this long before your race or your travel to the race to save yourself panic googling this video at midnight before you travel, or even worse, before you race. And remember, like your old rim brakes, check the pads regularly for wear, less than 1 millimeter on your disc brake pads, and they need replacing immediately. Enjoy your new disc brake bike. Good luck for your race. If you've enjoyed this video, remember to give us a like and subscribe for more GTN videos.